We want to find the equations of all of the asymptotes of the rational function, including any vertical, horizontal, or slant asymptotes. Before finding asymptotes, though, we normally want to factor the numerator and denominator to see if there are any common factors. Remember, the zeros of the common factors will give us wholes, not asymptotes. But in this case, the numerator and denominator do not factor. So we'll begin by finding the vertical asymptotes, which will occur where we have division by zero or where the function is undefined. So to find the vertical asymptotes, we'll set the denominator equal to zero and solve for x, which would give us 2x squared minus 3 equals zero. So we'll solve for x by first adding 3 to both sides. That would give us 2x squared equals 3. Divide both sides by 2. And so we have x squared equals 3 halves. And now we'll solve for x by taking the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, when doing this, on the right side we would have plus or minus the square root of 3 halves. So if we decide to rationalize this, we would multiply the numerator and denominator by square root 2, giving us x equals plus or minus, this would be square root 6 over square root 4, or square root 6 over 2. So the vertical asymptotes are x equals positive square root 6 divided by 2 and x equals negative square root 6 divided by 2. Next, we can determine the horizontal asymptote by analyzing the degree of the numerator and denominator. Notice in this case, the degree of the numerator is 3 and the degree of the denominator is 2. So for a quick review, if the degree of the numerator is greater than the degree of the denominator, then we do not have a horizontal asymptote. If the degrees are equal, then the horizontal asymptote is equal to the ratio of the leading coefficients. And if the degree of the denominator is higher or greater than the degree of the numerator, then the horizontal asymptote is y equals 0. So in our case, we don't have a horizontal asymptote, but we do have a slant asymptote because the degree of the numerator is 1 degree higher than the degree of the denominator. So to find the slant asymptote or oblique asymptote, we'll actually have to perform long division or divide the numerator by the denominator. So we would have 4x cubed minus 8x squared plus 2x minus 7 divided by 2x squared minus 3. To find the first term in our quotient, we want to know what times 2x squared would give us 4x cubed, and that would be 2x. Or if we wanted to, we could also perform division to find this first term. Notice 4x cubed divided by 2x squared would also give us 2x, the first term in our quotient. Now we're going to multiply 2x and 2x squared minus 3. So 2x times 2x squared would be 4x to the third. And then 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x or minus 6x. And we'll make sure we put this under the x term here. And now we're going to subtract by adding the opposite. So again, we can change this to addition if we change the sign of the terms inside the parentheses. This would be negative 4x cubed. This is plus 6x. So we bring down this negative 8x squared. And then here we have 8x. Let's also bring down this last term here. And now looking at this first term of 2x squared and this first term of negative 8x squared, we want to know what times 2x squared would be equal to negative 8x squared. And that would be negative 4. So we'll have minus 4 here. Now we'll multiply negative 4 and 2x squared minus 3. That would be negative 8x squared. And then plus 12. And now again, we're going to subtract by adding the opposite. So we'll change this to addition, change this to a positive, change this to a negative. And so our remainder is 8x. This would be negative 7 plus negative 12. That's negative 19 or minus 19. Which means the quotient is 2x minus 4, and then plus the remainder, 8x minus 19, over our divisor of 2x squared minus 3. And now to find the equation of the slant or oblique asymptote, we want to analyze what's happening to this quotient as x approaches positive or negative infinity. We'll notice how looking at this fraction here, since the degree of the denominator is higher than the degree of the numerator, as x approaches positive infinity, this fraction is approaching 0, which means our rational function would be approaching the line y equals 2x minus 4, which is the equation of our slant asymptote. So again, we have two vertical asymptotes, no horizontal asymptote, and a slant asymptote of y equals 2x minus 4. Let's go ahead and verify this by looking at the graph of our rational function. Notice how we have two vertical asymptotes, one here at x equals square root 6 divided by 2, which is approximately 1.22. And over here we have x equals negative square root 6 divided by 2. And then our slant asymptote here has the equation y equals 2x minus 4. And also notice, since we have a slant asymptote, we don't have a horizontal asymptote. I hope you found this explanation helpful.